Good morning, everyone. Now, today's a special day in school because at last we're welcoming back some more of you into school. Some more of you will come on Thursday, and then others of you will come a couple of weeks' time, and some of you, it'll be a while before you're back in school with us. But hopefully this is a good time where we're all able to come together and to be together in worship each week. When you do come back, school will look a little bit different to what you might be used to. But don't worry about that. We'll look after you as always. There'll be plenty of interesting activities for you to do as well. It will just be really lovely to see you all again. This week in our worship time, we're going to be thinking about our values of mutual respect and tolerance. Now, these are not words that we use in our everyday language all the time, but actually what they're really all about is accepting each other as we are, noticing and enjoying the ways in which we're the same or similar to each other, and also recognising and celebrating our differences, being proud of who we are, being interested in our differences and valuing everybody. So it links nicely with our value of belonging as well. Right, there's been a lot in the news in the past week or so about demonstrations in America and across the world, some even as close as Birmingham, because sadly, people are not always treated fairly in our world. And these demonstrations have been particularly about people being treated unfairly, even hurt or killed, because of the colour of their skin. Really sad. Sometimes, instead of realising that differences can make our world a much more interesting and better place, some people can be suspicious of anybody who's different to themselves. Sometimes this can even turn into hatred and aggression, which is really sad. It can make life ever so hard for some people. Our Bible story this morning is actually another of Jesus's parables, and it tells us something about this. It's all about valuing each other, not disliking someone just because they're from a different culture or because they do things or some things differently to us. It's a story all about breaking down some of those barriers. And actually, it's a story of love and kindness as well. It's one you'll probably recognise. It's the Good Samaritan. Jesus was teaching one day when a man in the crowd asked him a question. "Can you tell me, Jesus, what do I have to do to live forever?" Jesus smiled. "Love God," he answered, "and love your neighbour as much as you love yourself." "But who is my neighbour?" asked the man, hoping to trick Jesus. "Is he just the fellow who lives next door?" "Let me tell you a story," Jesus said, "and I think you will understand. Once upon a time, there was a man like any one of us, who was travelling from Jerusalem to Jericho. Now, as you all know, that's a very dangerous road. It's a twisty road, and it's a steep road, and there's no end of places for robbers and thieves to hide. Well, the robbers were waiting that day, and they grabbed the man, and they beat him, and they took his money, and then they left him on the floor to die." "Oh dear," sighed the crowd. They felt sorry for the man. Jesus went on with his story. "In a little while, another man came walking down that road, a priest, on his way home from worshipping God at the temple. He saw the dying man, and what do you think he did?" "He helped him," shouted someone in the crowd. "He saved him," shouted another. "No," said Jesus, "he did not. He took one look at that poor beaten man, then crossed to the other side of the road and walked away." "Oh my," the crowd murmured. "Wait," Jesus continued. "Soon another man passed by. He served God at the temple too. So what do you think this man did when he saw the wounded traveller?" "He ran for help," shouted someone. "He raised the alarm," shouted another. "No," Jesus said again. He did not. Just like the priest, he crossed to the other side of the road and left that poor man to die. Oh no, the crowd sighed. Don't worry, said Jesus, for there was one more man who passed by that day, and he was a Samaritan. A Samaritan? Shouted someone. They're different from us. We hate Samaritans, shouted another. And they hate us, added a third. So I've heard, nodded Jesus. But when this Samaritan saw the man, he did not walk away. No, he bandaged his wounds, he loaded him on his donkey, he took him to a nearby inn, and he paid for that man to stay there until he was better. Jesus looked at the man who had asked him the question. So, tell me, he said, which of these men was a neighbour to the man who had been robbed? The third one, the Samaritan, the man answered. That's right, Jesus smiled, because my neighbour is anyone who needs my help. Now, you go and help your neighbour too. Now, that is one of my favourite stories in the Bible, because it shows just how important it is to love, to respect, to value everybody. When Jesus lived on earth, Jews and Samaritans didn't get on at all well. They did things differently to each other. And it was even frowned upon for a Jew to speak to a Samaritan. How awful. But Jesus shows us in this story that it's not the group that we come from that matters. It's how we show love and the difference that we make in the world. The priest and the temple worker didn't show love, did they? Even though they were Jewish, like the injured man. Instead, it was actually the man from a different culture, the man who had different beliefs, who did things differently, who was supposed to be the enemy of the Jews. It was him who stopped and helped the poor injured man. He was that man's neighbour in the end. In the song we often sing in our worship times, we use Jesus' words, don't we? Love your neighbour as yourself and do to others as you'd have them do to you. And this is the story where Jesus shows exactly who he means by your neighbour, by our neighbour. It's not just the people next door, not just the people across the road. It's not just our friends or our family. It's not even just the people that we get on well with or the people who we're similar to. It's everybody. We should show God's love and be a good neighbour to everyone. Now, if you'd like to, I'm going to invite you to pray with me. Today's prayer is from our prayer book as usual, and this time it's from the mutual respect and tolerance section. Shall we pray? Dear God, thank you for making us who we are. Help us to love each other and respect each other's differences. We may not all be the same, but we can be kind to each other. Amen. Thanks to Summer in Year 4 for a really lovely prayer. That was absolutely perfect for our worship today. Now, before we look at the results from last week's challenge, I'm just going to take a minute to introduce this week's challenge to you. It's all about our values of mutual respect and tolerance. And in particular, it's based on the message from the story that we've heard today. I want you to design a poster with the slogan or the question, who is my neighbour? Make the words big and bold so that they can be easily seen. And then for the rest of the poster, I want you to think about the answer to that question, who is my neighbour? Because of course it's everyone, isn't it? So you might draw pictures of people of different ages, children, grown-ups, old folks. You might draw people with different coloured skin. You might show people from different religions. You might show people doing different jobs, or people with different pastimes, maybe people who support different football teams, people from different countries. It's up to you how you show it. I just want you to give the message to whoever sees your poster that everyone is your neighbour. You might also want to include Jesus's words, love your neighbour, because that gives a clear message as well, doesn't it? Again, you can use whatever you like to make your posters. Chalks, crayons, pencils, paints, collage. It's up to you how you go about it. But let's spread that message of love. Spread the message that everyone is important and that it's important that we show God's love to everyone. Right, now it's time to take a look at the results of last week's challenge, the recommend a book challenge. It's been great this week hearing from you about all the books that you've been reading. We've had a real varied selection, which is great. I've actually added one or two must-read books to my list for the summer, so thank you for those. Now, without any further ado then, let's get on and have a look at your recommendations.
This is my favourite book because it's funny.
My favourite book is Monkey Puzzle.
I recommend this book, I Love You Daddy, because it makes me happy.
I recommend Grants to Granny because it was very, very funny and I like it a lot.
I recommend this book, Moody Margaret Strikes Back, because it's very funny and interesting.
I recommend My Head Teacher the Vampire Rat because it's funny and it makes school sound fun, how the children go around believing their head teacher is a vampire.
This is a brilliant book by David Baddiel about a boy called Malcolm who changes into different animals. It really makes you laugh, so give it a go.
I like this book because the crocodile wore a tutu.
Hello everybody. Do you like princesses? I have a princess book, but it makes me sad and it makes me happy because it has a happy ending and the scary bits are where it has monsters in it.
Hello everybody, I recommend Mr. Gum because it makes me laugh and there's an interesting twist at the end.
Written in these walls are the stories that I can't explain. I leave my heart open, but it stays right here empty for days. She told me in the morning she don't feel the same about us in her bones. Seems to me that when I die, these words will be written on my stone. And I'll be gone, gone tonight. The ground beneath my feet is open wide. The way that I've been holding on too tight, with nothing in between. The story of my life, I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm in time. It's stays right here in its cage. And I'll be gone, gone tonight. Fire beneath my feet is burning bright. The way that I've been holding on so tight, with nothing in between. The story of my life, I'll take her home. I'll drive all night to keep her warm in time. Like chasing the clouds. The story of my life, I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm in time. is frozen. The story of my life, I give away.
What a great set of books. Might be worth having another look back at that section when you're trying to decide what book to read next. Now, in the last few days, you should have received an email about this year's Library Summer Reading Challenge. It's all online this year because of coronavirus. As usual, the challenge is to read 6 books over the summer period, or this time you can even set yourself a higher target, set yourself a real challenge. I wonder who in our school could read the most books over the summer. Theme this year is all about fun and laughter, it's actually entitled The Silly Squad. Plenty of books that we've seen today that could fit into that mould, I think. The fact that it's all online will hopefully make it even easier for everyone to take part, to get involved. So do take a look, sign up and get reading. Why not take a look back at the recommendations from today's worship to get you started? Okay, thanks for joining our worship again today. It's been really lovely to be with you all. Take care. God bless.